Welcome to chapter 7 of The Evil Within, my friends. This chapter is called The Keeper, and in this chapter there are 6 collectibles for us to obtain, as well as 4 keys. First things first, we're going to move towards the altar.
That sounded close.
It's alright, I'm here.
And we're going to pick up the first collectible, which is Map Fragment number 13. And now we just have to wait for Joseph to sit down on the bench, and then we can approach him and talk to him. Just wait for him to sit down. Come on, Joseph. And this will trigger a cutscene after you press X and talk to him.
Still with me?
Sebastian, you ever had the urge to just jump? When you're on a high place, or the subway rolls by. Imagine if you had that urge for a minute straight, then 2 minutes.
You fought it off 3 times now, Joseph. You're learning to stop it.
You're not listening. I'm not worried about stopping it, Seb. I'm worried about not wanting to stop it. Some part of me wants to turn. I don't know why. And I can't reason it away. It's deeper than that. It's like instinct. And it's getting stronger.
Hold on.
Okay, and this is how chapter 7 actually starts. I hope Joseph makes it, we'll see. This scene has such a big Inception vibe. After you cross down this set of ladders, you can pick up the green gel, as you saw. Make sure you break all these containers. Even though it's random, a lot of them contain green gel. In fact, you can obtain high amounts of green gel in this chapter. There's also a few handgun bullets, as well as a few parts. So lots of things to pick up in this room. So make sure you get them all. More green gel. And we're going to disarm this bomb now. And then pick up the handgun bullets. There we go. And gotta reload my gun. There we go. A few more containers to break. Above the next steps, there are going to be 3 enemies for us to defeat. But it's really simple, nothing to worry about at all. So what we're going to do is use the sniper rifle to... And what am I doing? Come on, Sebastian, get it together. Head up these steps and we're going to use the sniper rifle to kill one of the haunted who is walking towards us. He's patrolling this corridor. There he is. Don't worry about using the... ammunition, because you'll be able to get two sniper rifle bullets in this room. I wanted to dispose of them together, but I guess this dude fell in a different position. Oh, whoops. There we go. Stop right there. There we go. Nothing to worry about, because we'll be able to collect 7 handgun bullets in the next room, so we don't have to worry about using handgun bullets here. Jump out, Sebastian, come on. I hate when he lags like that. And here are the sniper rifle bullets. There we go. So we're going to move along the corridor into the next area. In this chapter we're also going to encounter not only a new boss, but also a new enemy called the Alter Egos, but they're really easy to handle, so we got nothing to worry about. Notice how that picture of that family broke and they're covered in blood now. That's really creepy.
Looks loose.
In this room we're going to find the first key, as well as the second collectible in the game. In this chapter. So first we're going to open this box, and inside there's a key. There we go. Pick up a few more parts, and the document is right here. Apparently there was a dude who was trapped inside this room, just like Sebastian is. And it's not a good foreshadowing when he says he's being followed by something. Obviously, I'm sure you guys have concluded that by now we will have to face that someone. And there he is, pounding at the secret passage. So what we need to do here is find the three pieces that are missing on these statues. The first one is already in. Now we're going to get a left path and a right path, which we can take. We're going to start with the left path, because if we don't take the left path first, we won't be able to obtain one of the keys in this chapter. So we're going to, like I said, start with the left chapter, with the left side, sorry. And we're going to turn this handle around to stop the release of the gas. And as we enter the next room, we're going to encounter a new type of enemies. Like I said, they're called the Alter Egos. If you shoot the guy that's hanging from that rope, you can actually trigger a trap. And I don't know why I didn't do that from the start, but I'll demonstrate nonetheless. Shoot him in the head, one sniper rifle shot is enough to kill them, and that triggers this trap. It can kill this guy right here on the floor, and that way you can spare one bullet. However, you're going to be able to pick up a few more sniper rifle bullets in this room, so you got nothing to worry about. Lower this trap and you'll kill the two Alter Egos that are standing inside that room, that way you don't have to waste any ammo on them. Pick up this grenade and set off this trap to pick up a few more parts. We'll need these parts because I will need to make a few freeze bolts, and freeze bolts are incredibly effective against the Alter Egos. But as I was saying, the Alter Egos, they're not really super difficult to deal with. They're actually very, very slow. You don't need to break open this door because there's an Alter Ego inside. There are a few handgun bullets inside, but it's not worth it. However, if you really want to have them, just knock the door open, use the axe to kill the Alter Ego inside, and then you'll be able to burn him. But as I was saying, the Alter Egos, the most dangerous attack that they have is an attack where they grab you and they drain your health. Sometimes there's like some sort of tentacle that appears from their chest and can grab you and deal damage to you. And they also have another attack where they can spit vomit at you. A la zombies in Resident Evil, in the original Resident Evil game. But again, it's really easy to avoid. They're really slow. If they sometimes they fall on the ground on their own, so it's really easy to deal with them. Now we're going to take this ladder down, and this is not a good sign. There he is, the keeper is the boss that we're going to have, that we're going to face in this chapter. And there is a trophy specific for this chapter, which is called... I don't have time for this, but we'll get to it once I reach the appropriate section. After we turn off this valve, there's going to be an alter ego who appears. Use the axe that you picked up from the other room to kill him, and then just burn him. As you can see, they're really easy to deal with. Then turn off this valve, and that will stop the release of the gas, and you don't have to worry about anything else. He didn't drop anything, nope. So let's keep going. A few more handgun bullets, don't need them. Two more green gel bottles here. And now we're going to point our gun at that detonator right there. Wait for the alter ego to pass, shoot it, and that might have been enough to kill him, or maybe not. There are two more alter egos, you can avoid them or kill them, that's completely up to you. I'm going to use my shotgun to dispose of this one. I should have gotten closer, that was silly. There we go. Notice how they have two faces, their human face and then their morphed face. I'm not going to waste bullets on you, Sunshine. So I'm going to turn around here, just disarm this trap. You have plenty of time to do all of this because, like I said, the alter egos are incredibly slow. So now we're just going to run towards the other end of the room, and we're going to turn off this handle to escape. You have plenty of time to do this before the alter ego reaches you. So you got nothing to worry about. As we move on to the next room, be careful because there's a trap on the floor, so you'll want to disarm that. Otherwise it will start releasing gas on the room, and we don't want that. There are a few alter egos who are crawling on the floor here, but we're just going to avoid them. Burn these two so that you can pass by them. There we go. And we're just going to turn this handle. None of them drop green gel, I don't think. So we're good, and as we step onto the next room, the first side is clear, and since we stopped the release of the smoke, you'll notice that that room right there is cleared of smoke, so we'll be able to obtain the key in that room now. If we had taken the right side first, we wouldn't be able to do so, and even if we went to the right side and then did the left side, we wouldn't be able to go back into the right side room. So left is the way you want to go. We're going to head towards the right side now. You can ignore the safe room for now, unless you feel more confident saving before entering the right side, but in my opinion, the right side is actually easier than the left side, so we shouldn't have a lot of problems. So first we're going to get another collectible, which is an audio tape. So we're going to listen to that first of all. Let's start it.
That cockroach, that sycophant, living off me, feeding off my work. I'll have to figure out how we got the combination to my safe. But there's no time for that now. I'm so close. No one can ever have that data. It is mine. My only way. Whoever opens that safe next had better be ready to pay the price.
So Ruvik had some sort of secret. There are a few items to pick up, and now we're going to get the second key in this chapter. So you want to release this chain right here, climb on top, and as you go up you'll see the statue standing in this pillar right here. There it is. So just shoot it or try and punch it. I shoot it because sometimes when I try and punch it, Sebastian falls down and I have to repeat the process, so might as well just use one bullet. There's a trap here on the floor, so you'll want to disarm it, otherwise you'll take damage, and you don't want that, of course. Let's disarm the trap first of all. There we go. And now we're going to shoot those two handles that you see up ahead. Don't stand underneath inside this room though, because if you do, this thing will fall on top of you, so you want to do this from the outside. Now get a freeze bolt ready, or whatever weapon you want to use. I think the freeze bolts will work really well against the alter egos. We're going to shoot the alter ego, wait for him to freeze, and then just break him apart. Don't stand too close to the enemy when you use a freeze bolt, otherwise you'll take a little bit of damage if you're in the radius of the blast, so you don't want that. In this room, we're not going to waste any bullets on any of the alter egos. There's a bunch of alter egos to beat in this room, but there's a pretty simple way to dispose of all of them. So we're going to first go through here, pick up the green gel, and there's a trap here, so you want to disarm that. Let's do it. And now you can either sneak towards the valve by this gate, or you can just run. It doesn't really matter. As you turn the valve, the door will open, and as you can see, a bunch of alter egos will come inside. I think there's at least 6 or 7 of them, but you don't want to waste any ammo on them. So what we're going to do is go back through this little passage, and now we're going to try and lure all the alter egos inside this area. And while they're inside, I'm going to leave through here and push that handle that you see over there, and hopefully I'll be able to crush all the alter egos at the same time. It's just a pretty effective way to save up a lot of ammo. As you can see, they fall on the floor as they do this, so I got them all trapped. Bye bye. See, it's pretty simple, and you'll be, hopefully some of them drop some green gel. Don't tell me only one of them did. Well, that's a shame, but better than nothing. So that's how you dispose of all the alter egos in this room rather easily. You just have to lure them inside that square. This is the treasure room. Like I said, if you didn't clear the left side first, this room will be filled with gas, and you won't be able to do this. There are a lot of traps on the floor, however, so you'll want to disarm them. This is the first one, and there's a second one a little bit further ahead. Just be careful where you step on. If you don't step on the ropes, you're fine. So disarm this trap as well. Apparently there's an alter ego around here, but I don't care. Now we're going to disarm these two traps. We do need to be careful, because if we miss the blue space, then, well, we could be in trouble. Second one disarmed, and there's another trap here, which is the last one. Let's disarm it as well. And now we can move forward, and we can pick up the key, as well as a bunch of green gel. More green gel. Let's break up the statue, and there it is. Key number 3 on this chapter. Remember that there are a few keys in the locker rooms, in the safe room, but they are placed randomly in certain lockers. But in order to obtain every key, you also need to obtain the keys in the lockers. However, those keys are obtained randomly, like I said, so whenever I open a locker with one of the keys, I'll show you the location. But in the actual chapter, in this chapter, there are only 4 keys. We're going to turn this handle now, and we're going to progress to the other room. There are three more alter egos to beat in the other room, but once again we're going to use the same strategy that we used against these three alter egos and just smash them with the traps that are set in this room. So as you can see them getting up, push this handle right here. There's another alter ego guarding the exit, but we're just going to run, jump back down. You don't want to go all the way towards the ceiling, otherwise you'll be crushed. And now we're just going to calmly wait here for the alter ego to join us. Come on, man, move it. As he falls, these dudes are so clumsy. We're going to push this handle. And there we go. Now we're going to move up the ceiling. And you'll enter this passage. Don't miss this passage, because if you do, you'll be crushed to death on the ceiling. And you don't want that. And here we go, the last key in this chapter. There's another grenade. I don't need it right now. I've got plenty. So let's head down. This can lead you towards the exit here, but I don't actually want to go there. Actually, I need to turn around. Yeah, because this would lead me towards the entrance again, and I don't want that. So instead we're going to pick up the green gel that these two alter egos dropped. And we're just going to move up. And here we go, the last piece of the statue. Now we are going to head in towards the safe room, where we will pick up three more collectibles. The last three collectibles in this chapter, pick up this green gel bottle. Inside this room we're going to find a journal. There we go. Hey, she had a good weight for a baby. And now we're going to head inside the safe room, where we will pick a newspaper article and also a missing persons file. Catacombs found. So someone found a secret passage underneath the church. Really creepy. And now let's get the missing person post. Chris. I wonder if he's the guy who wrote the file that said that he was stranded inside and that the keeper was following him. He probably was. So we're going to sit down and upgrade, do a few upgrades. First of all, I'm going to max out the amount of matches that I have, because I've been running to a bunch of them that I haven't collected, because right now I can only carry 15. And I'm also going to upgrade the reloading speed of my sniper rifle, since it's really low right now. And I'm going to increase the damage of my shotgun a little bit as well, because it's going to come in handy for the battle with the keeper. So right now my shotgun is able to deal a fairly big amount of damage. You might want to save your game at this point, just a small recommendation, simply because it would kind of suck to have to repeat everything if you reach this point but then for some reason get killed by the keeper or whatever. Anyway, just as a precaution, I'm saving my game. And now what we're going to do is place the two missing pieces of the statue, and we're going to progress towards the last section of this chapter.
Just one more.
You'll want to have a few explosive bolts, as well as at least one freeze bolt prepared for this upcoming fight. And it's in this section that you can obtain the I don't have time for this trophy. And to obtain this trophy, what you need to do is you can only take down the keeper twice. There are two sections during the boss battle with the keeper, where you have to mandatorily kill him, or at least dispose of him for a while. If you defeat him a third time, you won't be able to obtain this trophy. So there's a strategy to do this, and it seems to work rather nicely. But like I said, if you take down the keeper a third time, you won't be able to obtain this trophy. Plus, you'll just keep coming back anyway, so why would you? I don't have time for this. There are actually two trophies. I don't have time for these trophies.
Kidman? Is she here too?
Kid.
Is she alright?
Alright?
Stand back. I'll get it open.
Sebastian must have a pretty strong hand if he's able to break a chain, a metal chain, with a punch. I don't know why he's scared of the keeper. With those strong hands, he could just punch the keeper. Okay, so we're going to have our first mandatory fight with the keeper here. You have to take him down in order to progress towards the next room. With my sniper rifle upgraded as well as my shotgun, one sniper rifle shot and two or three more shotgun shots at close range will be enough to take him down. There we go. Whenever you defeat one of them, you'll be able to obtain 1000 green gel points. We're going to progress towards the next room, and as we progress towards the next room, we'll be able to pick up a couple of shotgun shells. Actually, it's not in this room, it's in the next one. Don't worry about him appearing, because you have enough time to turn off this valve before he can get too close to you. So quickly dodge him to the side and you'll escape the attack. The most important thing is not to panic. You have plenty of time to do this, so don't stop turning the valve just because it's getting close. And now in this room we'll have the second mandatory fight with the keeper. After this fight we can't engage him any more times, or defeat him any more times, otherwise we will not obtain the trophy. So here are the shotgun bullets, or the shotgun shells. Now we're going to turn off this valve. Have an explosive bolt prepared. At least I feel that the explosive bolts work really well here, so I'll use an explosive bolt followed by a couple shotgun shots, and that will take down the keeper. Obviously, if you're playing on the nightmare difficulty, it might take a little bit more to take him down, but even so, just use an explosive bolt or two and then just keep using your shotgun and you'll take him down in no time. So pick up the other green gel that he drops, and now we can't defeat him any more times, otherwise we won't obtain this trophy. I've already unlocked the trophy, so that's why you won't see it pop up on my window, but if you haven't obtained it yet and you're following my walkthrough, trust me, you will obtain it. So we're going to run towards this side and pick up the valve that's right over there. Have a freeze bolt prepared, and if we freeze the keeper in this area, we should have enough time to I didn't count on missing. Oh well, I guess I'll have to do a little bit of dodging. I'm right here, man, come on. There we go. Dodge him, and now I'm going to try and freeze him again. Hopefully this will do it. Might actually work more nicely. So he's frozen now. I'm going to run past him. Quickly. The more stamina you have, the better. We're going to place the valve here. And we're going to quickly turn it before he can come after us. If for some reason he reaches you before you turn off the valve, then just repeat the process. Use another freeze bolt, freeze him again, and you'll be good to go. Okay, he's right behind me, but as you can see, I had plenty of time to do this, and so will you. And here we are, out of the room. And that pretty much concludes this chapter. We still have a little bit of green gel to pick up, but we're going to head up this ladder here. Home free. Well, almost. What's in the box? A bunch of gruesome tentacles. Not this time, buddy.
Take this.
Well, that worked nicely.
Finally.
Though I'm not quite sure if we'll see this is the last that we see that we hear from the keeper. So we're going to head towards this room. First, we're going to this side right here. Because there's a green gel to pick up. This is the area where Leslie escaped into. And they show you the green gel during the cutscene. So it's only 800, but I think it's worth to come and get it. And now we're just going to head out. And like I said, my friends, this pretty much concludes this chapter. As always, I want to thank you all for watching, for taking the time to comment and liking my this video and just following the series. It means a lot. I hope you found this chapter useful. In order to obtain the I don't have time for this trophy, or the second part of the trophy, you actually need to complete the chapter, so don't just get it, don't just leave, abandon the chapter after you get rid of the keeper. You need to go all the way towards the end. But that's that. This chapter is over. It was actually pretty simple. So as always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all later. Take care.